but this is very apparently an important person. Look at how the sun rays shine through his taint. Oh, that is magnificent. That's a magnificent sight.
Love to all and welcome everybody. My name is Black Hollow and this is Maze. This is a game that NVIDIA chose to be part of their indie spotlight. And after multiple recommendations on Steam, I decided that I couldn't stay away. Whoa, what the hell? I think I took the red pill or the blue pill or both of them at the same time and I didn't have any food in my stomach. Holy shit. Whoa, okay. Alrighty, I got my visual settings in line. This shouldn't be happening. What is going on? What is going on? What is happening here? Okay, so I watched one trailer. Use WASD to walk. Use mouse to look around. Okay. Strange organ music. I used, I watched a couple of the trailers on Steam to check this game out. And I've been looking for new, fresh, exciting things to bring to the channel. Things with variety. Things out of the norm. And as you can see, this is clearly a video game adaptation of Signs starring Mel Gibson and Joaquin Phoenix, so I'm about to lose my shit in a minute here. No, but for real though, the trailer looked awesome. I have no idea what to expect. I have a tiny concept of what to expect. I know the genre. It is first person. It is fucking weird. That's about all I can say. But we'll likely discover things as we go along, so I won't ruin anything for you guys and I won't assume anything. What in the hell is that? Apparently this is Signs starring Mel Gibson. Can I go in the door? Really love to go in the door. When the pointing hand icon appears, click the left mouse button to interact. Open door panel! Okay, I can't do anything here. Okay, so we can do things here. A circular slot, a slot for a hand, and a slot for a key. So we need to probably find those three things before we do anything else at all. But let's follow the arrow for now and continue on. Press escape or P to enter the pause menu. Okay. Okay. I was like, this is turning into a maze. Oh no. But it's actually not really a maze. It's just kind of tomfoolery going on here. Oh wait, no, this part might actually be a maze. Pressing Q does absolutely nothing. Okay, noted. That's not the way to go, it's the other way. Let me see here. Hang the corner, find out if there's anything down. Aw. Now, you guys can go and support this game if you'd like on Steam. If you enjoy this opening episode, I recommend that maybe you check it out. But this is right up my alley of just being, like I said, fucking weird. Really weird. And I also like first-person shooters. Or not first-person, first-person perspective, I should say. It's not a shooter. But you guys didn't know that yet. Click the left mouse button to pick up items when the grab icon appears. Okay, you did a great job. Aww! Tell me something. Inventory you can use will be added to your inventory. Story items will be added to your folio. Item added to folio. Okay, great. How do I open up either of those things? G-R-F-E-E. English muffin. Hard as granite, this muffin is most definitely nowhere near fit for consumption, despite how much you try. All you've done is given yourself a headache. Okay? Q doesn't do anything. Tab, caps lock. I'm trying to find... Oh, that's the crouch button. Here, give me a second, you guys. I'm gonna go through my key bindings. What? There's no customizing? Aw. Okay, well, there's no customizing then. In that case, we will just have to deal with it. This is going to be the folio then. Welcome note. Welcome, something it says. A note lazily scribbled includes a stock greeting and encourages the reader to enjoy the complimentary snack on the desk. Notes to the reader to mind the boxes and also says, open the big door and we'll probably say hello. Probably. Okay, anything else here? I don't think so. So let's hit the space bar and get out of that and move on. We will enjoy the snack. Press E to examine your equipped item for clues on how to use it. Well, I got the clues right there. English muffin, yes. I've got it right clicked, but I can't do anything with it. Oh, wait a minute. It's probably the circular object that needs to go back there. I betcha that's what it is. I betcha. Okay, let's keep searching through here. We got some arrows over here. But let's come back this way. We can sprint now that I looked up the key binding for it. There's a house over here. Press the space bar to look at story items in your folio. That I did. Unfortunately, I can't scroll through anything right now. I don't even have a mouse or anything like that. So let's get out of there and push forth over. Aw, this is cool. Oh, this is mysterious.
super awesome secret stuff.
What's over here? We got a nice little bench. A couple of stutters. This is a new game. It's to be expected. When you see the place icon, you can use an item. Click the left mouse button to use your equipped item. Okay, that's not it then. I need a key in order to get through there, I think. Or something of the sort, maybe. Is there anything back here, possibly? No? Okay, then let's go back over. Whence we came. I'm assuming that this is... Yeah, that's got to be the pathway then. Oh, broken shovel handle. Equip inventory items by using the scroll wheel or the 1 and 2 keys. Okay, so we have a broken shovel handle. And oh, we can scroll to not having an item. That's always nice. I don't see anything else in here. That's pointing us in that direction. So I'm not entirely sure where the other path went. But this is very apparently an important person. Look at how the sun rays shine through his taint. Oh, that is magnificent. That's a magnificent sight. What? No more fucking around. Let's go over to these Nike shoe boxes. Can I please get around these? No, I can't. Maybe I can use the broken shovel handle to do something with them? No, I can't. Maybe if we go back the other way. I want to try to make this first episode a bit of a Let's Play style episode so that way we can see what the game is all about, you know? And we don't have to worry about cutting around and getting to the important stuff. Let's discover this together. And you guys in the comments down below, let me know. Do you want to see... Oh, is that it? Literally, that's it? Okay, alrighty. So I guess I'm supposed to either find something or use that broken shovel handle on the door over there. How about we try that out? Let's try that out. Because we have the circular object. And I'm assuming that's what we need for the door back there. There's got to be something inside of this house then. Or around it, one of the two. A locked door. Okay, well, I clearly can't do anything with that. Is this anything? No, it is not. It is just a errant piece of paint. What about over here? Is there anything over here? I don't see anything apparent. This? What is this? What is this? Can I do something with this? I can probably, but I haven't figured it out yet. There is a... And I can't jump. Oh, but I can just randomly hop up on things. That's it. Hey, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. That's the thing that I'm looking for. Let's keep discovering. Discovery is awesome. What's in here? Okay, open chicken coop door. Okay, anything in here that I need? Yes, there is a key. We have the circular object, we have a key, and we need one more thing, I believe. This may be something that we use to get into the house, but before I aimlessly run away from here, I just want to double check and make sure that there isn't anything else going on. To go back to the house, or to continue on. Onward we go! Let's continue. No matter how many times you press it, Q still does nothing. Good to know, game. Good to know. Because, I'm not hitting it. I'm not hitting it at all. What is this? A rusty nail jammed in a wall. I can't grab it, okay? Here's a mediocre rock. Item added to folio. Scroll to the mediocre rock. This is a rock you found near an outhouse. You don't know why you have it. It is absolutely mediocre in every way possible. Its name is Chauncey. Well, it is not mediocre then. That is awesome. Oh man, they gave the rock. I just love this game, like the humor about it and what I saw. And it's totally living up to the quote unquote standard, I guess you should say, or could say, that I had for it to have while we roam around and whatnot. It's not boring, I'll put it that way. It's not boring. Now I don't know if we can get in the back door over here. No, we can't, so we need to go to the front door. We do have the key now though. We've got the key. Farmhouse key. So that must go here. Yay! Open farmhouse door. So satisfying. We can't do anything with that shoe or that circular item. Looked like that was a note for a second. Wow, this is dark. This is pretty damn dark. Can I turn the lamp on, please? No. Okay, apparently not. Hey, but at least we can see what we need. Item added to the folio. What is it? An invoice for a commissioned wooden statue. Cost is in the hundreds of thousands. Items on the list include chopping down a large oak tree, carved statue out of oak tree, and hospital bills for injuries sustained chopping down oak tree. That sounds like an episode of Axemen. Anything else over here? I don't think so. I don't see anything at all. So let's exit this room. Exit stage right! And we will move over here to find out if there's anything in here. Nothing I can see. Oh, what is this? A really boring mystery novel. Item added to folio. Having no talent at the genre, the author mistakenly revealed the murderer's identity on the first page and spent the rest of the novel outlining a story about the detective buying a pair of pants. Oh, it's so funny. Oh, it's so witty. Oh, it's so out of the norm. I was really expecting to do something stupid with that outlet right there, but I guess the game dev thought about me being a dumbass in this game. We'll go upstairs in a minute. We don't need to go up there right now. What is this? A sausage grinder. Something is jammed inside. Can I pull it out, please? No, apparently I can't. Fruit crate. I got me a fruit crate. Okay. Oh, I already used the key. I'm like, where did the other thing go? A bathtub plug. Okay, we got the bathtub plug. An old sink. The sink is now plugged. Okay. I didn't realize that that was what I was aiming to do, but it happened and I did it and I'm okay with it. Rancid corn oil. Can I pour this into the sink? Yes, I can. Poured rancid corn oil in sink. The smell is worse than imagined. I don't even know why I did it, but I did it just to do it, I suppose. I can't get anything else out here. Oh, press C to crouch and C again not to crouch. You can do this forever. Confirmed. Oh no, it stopped doing it. I can't do it. I can't do it anymore. I can't do it. I'm just kidding. I'm hitting Q. Okay, so this is a concealed switch of some sort, but I don't believe that there's anything else I can do in here. Kitty litter. Why would you keep the cat box in the kitchen? That is just dumb. Unlocked a secret door, making it much less secret. Okay. So someplace a door opened up in here. It is probably upstairs. Can I do anything with this? Still? No, I can't. Can I do anything with this? No, I can't. Oh, open the medicine cabinet. What is in here? Nail clippers. Can I throw anything into the... No, okay. I was gonna say, can I dip anything into there at all? No, I can't. So let's go upstairs and find out where that secret door opened. Hello? Anybody? Anything? What is this? Bobby pin. Okay, that'll be useful for picking locks or pinning bobbies. Do we have anything over here? Nothing that I can see. Some things look like you can touch them and interact with them, but then you get close to them and you realize that it's just a disappointment and no, you can't. Ooh, a wobbly wardrobe! You don't say. We'll investigate that in just a moment here because that is very obviously the important thing in the room, but I don't want to miss anything else, such as, but not limited to, another can of rancid oil. Okay, alrighty, there isn't anything else, so let's just go ahead and do this. Item can be placed here. Sounds good to me. Place the fruit crate on the floor. Okay. I keep thinking that I can jump there, but I can't. I can't do anything else, really. The tipped wardrobe! Oh, tip the wardrobe over with the broken shovel handle. Okay, I see. So we're using things and leaving them behind. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is the secret passageway to the attic! What do we have in the attic? Is that a grapefruit? No, that's a lamp of some sort of a bulb. We have a mirror. We have a cobweb. That's a very nicely rendered cobweb. Gnome! Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows my sorrow. Mallet, and an item can be placed here. What is it? Nail clippers, bobby pin, mallet? No, it's something that I have yet to find. Something I have yet to find, but I feel like I've found most things here. Can I jump out the window? No, I can't, because spacebar, yet again, does not provide me with a jump function. That is weird. Who are you? You look weird. He looks like the guy that the statue was made out of. Anything over here? No. Nothing with the clock. There's gotta be stuff over here. Whoa! Hey, what are you? What are you? What are you? A burnt lab report. Item added to the folio. Much of it can't be read, but the words abject failure appear several times. So does hurt feelings, sentient corn stalks, and why did we do this? Dual question marks. That right there. The dual question marks, that says it all. Or asks it all. One of the two. Or two question marks. Yeah, you guys get what I'm putting down. Now, I don't know what else I can do in here exactly. There has to be some more stuff. Someplace or somewhere. But I am challenged to find it. I really am. Nothing that I can see immediately. It's usually pretty easy to spot things. If I can place an item here, and it's none of the items that I have, then I believe I may be done here. Maybe, just maybe, we use the mallet on the... Wait, what if I crouch? And then if I go around? Is there anything if I crouch and I go around? Maybe not. Probably not. Let's get out of here. Yeah, let's move on from here. Because I believe that we have accomplished all the goals that need to be accomplished here. Is this a thing? No, it is not. Yeah, we have definitely found everything that needs to be found. We can move on from here. Still nothing we can do with those guys, and nothing we can do with those guys either. Are you something? No, you are not. I really feel like we can leave the house. I feel like the farmhouse is done. Yeah. Yeah, I'm feeling it. Okay. See you later, farmhouse. We are out of here. Well, actually, I think about it. I believe I searched every room, but I haven't really tried using maybe the bobby pin on here. No. Mallet. No, I cannot. Okay, alrighty, I tried everything. And I can't open up the back door, which is unfortunate. So we will just have to move on. Yep, that is everything. I have a sneaking suspicion that I can use the mallet on that wall of boxes. Let's find out if I'm right. Let's find out if I am right. Because if I am, that'd be great. Because I didn't see anything back there in the farmhouse. This is just a theory. Just a running theory. Did I go the wrong way? Damn it. Okay. All right. Let's go back this way then. Wait. Why would they tell me about the rusty nail if I couldn't do something with it? English muck. Nail. Yeah! Pulled the rusty nail out of the wall with nail clippers. Okay. Is this the thing that we can place over there? Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Is there something going on in here now that I pulled the rusty nail out? I don't believe there is. Not that I can see. And I don't remember anything else really being out of the ordinary over here. So let's continue past this. Sentient corn! What does that mean to you guys? What does sentient corn mean to you? Let me see here. Well, part of me wants to go back in there and... Oh! Ooh! Yes. Bobby pin. Well, I can't... It's like highlighted, but I can't like even really aim at it. I can't... Rusty nail. Yeah, I can't even aim at it. Like, it's highlighted. It's very apparently a thing, but I can't do anything with the thing. Let's go back this way. And let's try using the mallet on the first set of boxes that we found over here. I don't believe that there was anything else that we could do. I don't think so. Windmill. Can I do this? No, I can't. Ah, shit. What do I do? Where do I go? What do I do? Product WT-40. That's funny. That is funny. Okay, so I'm going to try and see if maybe... Yeah, I don't... I don't have anything that can be placed here. Oh! That was the secret door! Not the one upstairs! Oh! Okay! Oh! See, I knew the basement had to be a thing, but I didn't know how to get there. Well, we're here, and it's a lot more underwhelming than I thought it would be. I was expecting, like, chrome walls. I was expecting all kinds of stuff. Hang on. Latch. There we go. Opened up the cellar doors. Let's get some air in here because I smell the mold, mildew, and bullshit left and right. There's something going on over here. Fuse box is missing a fuse. Do we need to find a fuse? Where can we find a fuse? Probably somewhere around here. I'm going to try to eliminate as much of that walking around you guys as possible because I did commentate trying to find what I needed to find for quite some time. Who the hell are you and why do you have boobs? Nice eyebrows. Somewhere around here there has to be a fuse. Is there something up here, maybe, that I missed when the door swung open? Probably not. Okay. We'll do a little bit of searching. No worries. We'll figure our way through this. I'm a little worried, though. I mean, wouldn't you be? Wait, can I use a nail? Used a rusty nail as a fuse against safety regulations. See, I gotta start thinking outside of the game. Or inside of the game. Restored power to the farmhouse. It is slightly less dark than it was before. Okay, good. So there's probably some things that we can discover inside of the farmhouse. In the rooms that were once rather dark. I'm hearing things happening above me. Am I the only one that's hearing that? Yeah, this right here. This is CD player. Opened up the CD player and grabbed the CD. You picked up a CD. Good for you. A new path is opened up to you to the barn and the silo. Very cool. Okay, so we have the barn and the silo opened up and ready to go. Let's go ahead and venture off that way and see what we have in our midst. Again, you guys, this is going to be a more Let's Play style episode. Please let me know. Yeah, I figured that out a while ago. Thank you, game. Please let me know in the comments down below. Do you want to see a heavily edited series that brings you the best of? Because this is apparently a full-fledged game. Or would you rather see something that's a little bit more on the side of, you know, constant gameplay for the most part? If you're stuck, remember to press E to examine your equipped item for clues. Okay, I already did that. I suppose that I could use that to my advantage from time to time, but for the time being, I am faring quite well. I just missed that secret door. That was really the only thing. Who gives a shit about what's around it? Let's go inside of it. No more exploring the perimeter hollow. Let's try and take the path that the devs intended that we take. I don't see anything glowing. That's the one nice part about this game, is that it's very easy to see the things that that you need to interact with. So far, I'm not seeing any of them, though. Hey, there's one! A book titled Corn of the World, item added to the folio. A book outlining the differences and the similarities of corn species across the globe. Several chapters also discuss the color yellow. A few species are circled in red pen, while no appears in many places across the entire book in blue pen. Okay, alrighty. Well, something is going on with corn, that's for damn sure. How about we go up the stairs instead of going outside? How's that sound, you guys? Let's find out what's up here. Anything? Anything at all? We have a broom! Just gonna turn into the Sorcerer's Apprentice up in here. We have one half of a diagram. Okay, so we need the other half somewhere. We have a glove that I can't interact with, and a hat, of course, that I can't interact with, and another hat that I can't interact with. What does the hat say? Rain... Reindeer. I was gonna, and it's funny because it's a fucking reindeer. I was gonna say, like, I found a bottle. I don't know if I'll leave it in the episode or not. I found a WD-40 bottle or spray can, whatever, with WT-40 written on the side of it, and I thought that was pretty funny. I don't see anything over here. I can't jump up there because jumping isn't a thing. Get pumped! All right. I don't think there's anything else for me to have up here. So maybe we can continue on. We'll explore the perimeter before we leave. And then we'll go to the, we'll go to the silo. Because we're obviously at the barn itself right now. Not necessarily the barn house, but the barn itself. There's a pathway down there. But first and foremost, let me check back here. There is another pathway. Is that the silo? Yeah, that's to the silo. Okay, alrighty. So I can't go the other way. I thought if I backtracked and went the other way, then I'd be able to do, you know, the path through the other boxes. But I suppose I can't. Hello, a padlock. Bobby pin would go well in there. Unlock the padlock with the bobby pin. Great. Let's find out what's inside of the silo. Maybe we could take a step back and, you know, not have the grain fall. Okay, alright. I was going to say, usually grain comes flying out of these things. A pile of corn kernels, okay, and an old telescope, item added to the, where did I put that? Manufactured about a century ago, this telescope's effective range is the tops of low-hanging trees, possibly because its lenses were put on backwards. Looks like it was used frequently, with varying results. See, there's just so much to this game. I like the Let's Play style, a weathered, tattered blueprint. Though it's hard to make out, this blueprint looks like it's for the construction of a very large and poorly planned facility, with a farm situated on top of it. The facility itself actually set an agricultural record for having the largest number of corridors that lead absolutely nowhere. Agreed! Agreed! I concur with that statement. Okay, so I can't do anything with the corn kernels. I cleared the pyre of corn kernels with the broom, and I found some pliers. Very nice. Very, very nice. Can I do anything over here? I cannot. Is there anything else in the silo for me to be had? No, there is not, so we will leave. Let's get back over to where we're supposed to be. I'm really enjoying this game so far, you guys, because normally games like this, they just set you up immediately in the beginning, and they go overboard. This has a... Stop pressing Q. I'm not pressing Q. I'm not... I press Q when you tell me not to press Q. And what is this? Some sort of Tesla coil of some sort? What are you? Single corn stalk? Okay, so we can't go over there, obviously. What is this? Big green button? Can I push the big green button? No, I can't. Whoa, hello! Who are you? Who are you? You look like you got, man. That's more grounds than you need and more positive leads than you need. I'm gonna need the glove severed hand. Oh, and I know exactly what I'm gonna use with that. A very fashionable fedora. And we will read it before we pick that up. A very fashionable fedora worn by a fashionable person. Due to this, you are not putting it on your head, as you have not earned the right. On the inner tag, the owner wrote his name, Fernando. That's a Lady Gaga song, I think. And a tattered name tag. A charred name tag. It took you several hours of staring, but you managed to deduce that the name tag, in fact, belongs to the dead person it was near, and that his name is Fernando. It took you several more hours to notice that the dead person was a lab assistant, and then five more minutes to realize you were trying to read the thing upside down the whole time. Oh, game, you make me giggle snort. You make me giggle. What is inside the toolbox? Absolutely nothing, okay? Can I interact with you at all? Because you look special to me. I guess I can't. Can I do anything over here? No, I can't. No, I can't. There's nothing on this for me to interact with. So, there is nothing. Okay, so in that case, we will return to whence we came. Oh, hey, Tractor. Hello, how are you today, Tractor? I can't do anything past this point. That doesn't seem very safe now, does it? Can I interact with you at all? No, I can't. Well, at least I know that you're here for the future. So there's one thing I realized that we did not do as we enter the farmhouse, and that is search this room over here because the lights came on, and there may be something else in here for us. I don't think there is, though. Yeah, I don't think there is. Part of me just leaves these parts in for you guys so that you know that I'm actually exploring everything. I'm doing my best not to overlook things, but I also want to edit out any fluff or backtracking that we may need to do. Can I do anything with this? Can I do anything with this? Anything? 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 Oh my god! Loosen the glove from the severed hand! Slightly disgusting! Okay, so we got the glove. I don't need the hand? I would think that I need the hand for the thing, Bob, that we found on the way in. Oh, I have the hand. I left the glove. Needle-nose pliers. Boom. Pulled a warped key fob out of the sausage grinder. Not an ideal place for it. I agree. And you want to know where that fob goes? That fob goes upstairs into the attic. That's where we can place it. That's where it happens. That's the next step. All right. Do your worst, key fob. Place warped key fob on the workbench. Okay. I don't think that accomplished very much, though. Do I use an item on it? Mallet. Oh, the key fob has been smashed good and flat. Very nice. Okay, so we have the circular object. We have the key fob. And we have... Very nice. So you know what, you guys? We finally, I believe, get to go back to the door that we were at in the beginning, and we get to open it because I think we have the circular device necessary to open it up. This way to the door. I like how they have the signs planted all around because believe me, I would have forgotten. And now I can understand why they call this game Maze. Wow, it's a pretty game though. It's a very pretty game. Very, very pretty. Okay, the door is just on the left over here, I believe, if memory serves. I think. Possibly. No. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, this is gonna be tricky. Oh crap. Is it right there? No, damn. There we go. There it is. That took a minute. That took a minute, but I found it. Okay, so this requires the CD. Top secret? Way to label it? This requires the severed hand. And this, ladies and gentlemen, the key fob. Here we go! Oh joy, oh joy, oh joy, we figured out the first puzzle. This game is puzzle-based if you haven't figured it out already. What? Hello? Hello? Who's there? Oh, I hear a rustling. What could that be? Huh?
Hey!
Huh?
Hey!
Hey! Oh, hi, corn. Wow. Sentient corn.
You must answer a riddle before you're allowed to enter.
Okay?
A doctor and his son are in a car accident.
No, not that one. Say the one about the guy who hung himself with an ice block.
I know both of them.
Take that one away. Answer this one. What animal walks on four legs in the morning?
That one's boring.
I know all three.
I'm riddle president today. I get to pick.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh my god. Corn is talking!
An empty bus pulls up to a stop and 10 people get on. At the next stop, 5 people get off, and twice as many people get on as at the first stop.
Okay.
At the third stop, 25 get off. So, which one of us is named Jim? Am I Jim? I thought he was Jim. No, that's Bill.
Where's Bill?
You're Bill.
That's right.
Okay, as we sort this all out, let's hope you're better than the last one.
Oh my god, you guys. Holy shit. This... it's gonna be one hell of a ride.
Watch out for our brother down there. He's a bit odd.
Okay. That sounds good to me, guys. And I believe that that is gonna do it. Well, that was unexpected. You're telling me. You are telling me that is gonna do it for this episode, you guys. Please leave a comment down below and let me know what you think about this series because I am in love. You can expect me to be playing more of this, absolutely. But let me know if you want to see more of a solid Let's Play episode. Or actually, you know what? Hang on. Wait. Can I? Yeah, there's got to be auto saves or something like that. A button. I hit the button. Hiya, Ted. Don't worry about it. I'll reset the elevator after a few more months of data we overbought on food pellets. And we have to get rid of them somehow, okay? Bob, I told you to fix this elevator weeks ago. It takes hours for everyone to get in here because of your stupid experiment. Moron. Cordially, Ted. That's like a passive-aggressive roommate. That is funny. That is funny indeed. You pressed a button. That I did. There's another one over here. What is this? You ate a stale pellet. Okay. Now what? Do I have to... What's going on? 1, 0. This it? I hit the button again? Shit! What do I... 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, button. Hit the button. Eat the pellet. 8, 7, 6, 5. I am so confused, you guys. I'm gonna figure this out, and we will continue on from here in the next episode. So, friends, if you enjoy what you see, and only if, leave a little love in the comment section, or leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss the rest of whatever the hell comes next. And as usual, enjoy the rest of your day. And I will see you guys again.